Afterwards, you have your cycle test. Yes, you have today and Friday, Tuesdays and Fridays, you will be having your cycle test. You'll have to learn and write all your cycle test well. Do you remember when is your social cycle test? When is your social cycle test? 19th. Fine. So very good. You all remember that. You all have noted down all the dates. Good children. So yes. So we have been learning about all these civilizations. This lesson is little big lesson because we have to learn about all these civilizations. Anyhow, we are not going to learn anything in detail, like fully all that details we are not going to learn. Just as a glimpse of that we all are learning. Yes, but we will be learning about all these civilizations. Earlier you have just heard about the Egyptian, Chinese, Mesopotamian civilization, Indus Valley civilization. But here inside that there are some of the groups were there. All that only we all are learning, how the society was, what kind of work they were doing. That is why it takes some time, because when you learn this, you have to learn all that, because after this you all are not going to learn about civilization unless if you choose a subject in your college. Okay, only if you are going to learn history in your college, then only you will be learning something in detail. But other than that, this learning about civilization will get over this year itself. That is why I'm just dealing all that details to you. Fine children, so let us continue from there without wasting the time. Yes, so yesterday we have seen about the Mesopotamian civilization. In that we have learnt about Sumerians, Akkadians, Babylonians and Assyrians we have to see. After the Assyrians, we have to learn about their society, state and administration, food and agriculture, how they did trade and how they planned their cities and everything we will learn. Okay, what was their religion, what kind of writing they had, what kind of art they developed. So we have to learn all that. That itself will take time today. Okay, so after that, in the next class, we will be learning about the Chinese civilization. Fine children, so let's get into the lesson. All this we have learned. Babylonian civilization we have learned. Okay, here we were learning about Babylonians. Yes, the last point what we have learned is the height of the empire began in the 18th century. That means they started growing in 18th century and lasted to the 17th century. And this was a great power which lasted for about 100 years. Yes, so next one we will learn about relationship to the surrounding people. You can see this map here. This is Mediterranean Sea. This is Mediterranean Sea. Yes. Here you can see Egypt, Upper Egypt. This is Lower Egypt. After you get this PPT, you will see here. And here only Mesopotamia, which is now called Iraq. Okay, near Mediterranean Sea, this is only Mesopotamia. Okay, here. Okay, fine children, so let's continue here. Hammurabi. Okay, Hammurabi was a person who united many of the civilizations which was around, okay, which was around that place. He united everything into the single one to his empire, to his civilization, that is under the Babylonian rule. including all that Assyrians, Akkadians, Sumerians, all come under now one. Earlier we had Assyrian separately, Akkadian separately, Sumerian separately. Now this Babylonian king Hammurabi, okay, made all the civilizations under Babylonian rule. They traded with Anatolia, Syria, Palestine, all these places they had trade. And after Hammurabi united all the kingdoms, they adapted the Akkadian language. What language they adapted? Akkadian language for their official use. That is, official language was Akkadian language. For religious purpose, Sumerian language. For religious purpose, Sumerian language. Official language was Akkadian language. Religious purpose, they used Sumerian language. So these were the Babylonian gods and goddesses. Marduk. Okay, Marduk was a god. And Ishtar. This is a goddess. Tiamat. Okay, another god. Tiamat. So Marduk, Ishtar, Tiamat. What kind of government they had? So I told you what kind of government they had. We will see. The main form of the government was monarchy form of government. We had heard this word many times. Monarchy means single rule, the king's rule. Whoever was selected as a king or whoever belonged to that king's family, they only will be ruling that kingdom. Same way, that time itself, this kind of king's rule started. So it was a monarchy form of government. And these kings used to maintain, that is, used to appoint governors in order to maintain the law and order in that place. Okay, so see there, that time itself, governors were appointed to maintain the law and order and control over the different provinces. Different provinces means different places. Okay, and they used that book called, we now say constitution. That time they used the Hammurabi code of law. Nowadays, what kind of book we follow, that is constitution, which contains all the rules and regulations. That time they used, Babylonians used Hammurabi code of law because it was created by Hammurabi, and that is why the name is given as Hammurabi code of law. It was the first uniform code of laws which reinforced class distinctions. Okay, here that time itself they had a lot of classes, and here you can see Avilu, a person of the upper class. Avilu means he belonged to the upper class. Mushkenu, low estate. Mushkenu, low estate. Vardu, he...
Excuse me, ma'am. I need to just give an information to the children. Mama, ma'am, can you hear me? Students, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Okay, okay. Mute your... Today is your first cycle test. Hope you all have prepared well. Your teacher, when they come to take the class today, they will revise with you. If you have any doubts, you can request to unmute you and you can clarify your doubts. In the evening at 4 o'clock, you will receive the paper. When you receive the paper, answer in a neat sheet of paper. Most of you would have got your test notebook. In your test notebook, you have to use the unruled notebook formats and do your test as you do it in school. And then you scan it, convert it into PDF and upload it immediately. So whoever is new, who doesn't know how to deal with it, can clarify how to go about it with your teacher, or you can even call the school office. We will tell you what to do. Thank you. All the best. Yes, ma'am. You can go ahead, Mama, ma'am.
Ma'am, you are not audible.
Ma'am, you are muted.
Children, you are able to hear me now? Okay. So we have seen the social differences, children. There were a lot of laws created by Hammurabi, and it was given there in the Hammurabi Code of Law. But still, there were some laws for the women also to protect the women. Also, some laws were there. Let's see about Assyrian civilization. You can see the structure. This is, we can imagine like whether these kind of people lived there, this kind of art was there, whether this kind of what is that, buildings were there. We may be thinking about it with some imaginations. All these are given, but remember children, those people used, they knew how to draw, they knew how to paint. So all these are okay, we can say that these kind of pictures, whatever you see, are nearly 60% or 70% true. Really, those people lived with a lot of luxurious life at that time. So Assyrian civilization, before I go into that, like I wanted to say, 2 days back, if you had to see the news, you would have heard about the archaeologists telling about the people, height, okay, the people who lived in the world, the highest people, we can say that. Okay, they are more in height. So same way I have shown you in the first lesson also with the biggest or the longest skeleton I have shown you, the biggest skull also I have shown you. Really, those kind of people lived there at that time. So I wanted to confirm that message earlier itself. Now I had the time to tell you. Those kind of people lived there. Even the Europeans who are considered as the tallest people, like 7 feet or something, they are half to them. Their height is half to them only. They have compared and shown 2 days back in the news regarding the archaeologists shown through that. Fine, children. So let us see about now Assyrian civilization. This is the name derived from city Ashur on the Tigris River. Euphrates and Tigris River, I have told you. So Tigris is another river, and this was considered as the original capital for their country. Okay. And actually, it was a small place, like a colony from Babylonia only. From the Babylonian civilization, it was only a colony. From there, it has developed into an Assyrian civilization. Okay. So you can see the year 1900 BC, Ashur, the capital of Assyria, is founded. This Assyrian empire was politically active. Politically active means they were well-versed in political administration. They were well-versed in political administration, and the Assyrian kings were the priests of Ashur. The Assyrian kings were the priests. So because we have seen that mostly priests were considered as the upper class, and they were having the control over the people, we have seen. So here also the Assyrian kings were the priests of the Ashur, or we can say that the chief deity of Assyria. Then Assyrian government was controlled by the emperor. Whoever was considered as emperor, the total control was under the emperor, because it was a monarchy form of government. Okay, monarchy form of government, king's rule. And you can see Ashurbanipal was a popular ruler. Among all the rulers and the emperors, Ashurbanipal was a popular ruler, because he maintained a famous library of cuneiform records. So what kind of writing they had? Cuneiform writing. It was a method of writing. What is the form of writing called? Cuneiform writing. He maintained a library for that cuneiform methods itself. Who? Ashurbanipal. And they were the first empire who created the military force in the history. This Assyrian empire were the first people who created the military force. And not only that, they emerged the military powerful because they were the earliest to use iron technology effectively. They started using the iron in a very effective manner by making lot of weapons and tools so that they were able to maintain the military. Okay? You can see here the map. This is Egypt. Here Babylonia I said. In that Babylonia, this is Babylon. Here Sumer. And here Ur. This is Assyria, which is given in green color. Assur was the capital, I said. Nineveh is another place. This is Mitanni state. This is Hittite Empire. So all these places were there. So this is, map is about ancient Egypt and Mesopotamia. You need not practice all this map, just to know about where these places are. Okay? So this is the Babylonian form of writing numbers. Babylonian form of writing numbers. This is their numeral system, which began around 5,000 years ago. And it was an early numeral system developed from based on 10. Okay, there was also a system which was based on 60 also. Okay, 60. First, they started with the tally marks. You all do it in the bar graph. Yes, in the same way, they also have started with the tally marks. And the Babylonian system contained 60 characters. How many characters? 60 characters. And all their letters, the symbols for their numbers were wedge-shaped. You can see here, it is all like wedge-shaped. So you can see, let us see some numbers here. You can see the symbol for number 1, 2. Now, Roman numbers we use, no? Like one single I for 1, 2I for 2, 3I for 3. Same way you can see here, 3. And this is 4. All the 3 put together and see, you can see like a funnel shaped or triangle shaped. And this is 5. You can see that holes alone counted as 5 here. Top 3, bottom 2. And you can see here, 6, top 3, bottom 3. Just I'm showing it to you how they have done it. See, this is for 8. And you can see here for 18. So that means this wedge shaped denoted 10. This wedge shape denoted 10. And this is 20. You can see here 30. And again, you can see here for 40. How it is. This is for 50. So these kind of tally system started 5,000 years ago. Let us see the society, state, and administration of the Assyrians. They had the class, different classes. The first class, king and nobility. Second, priest. Third one, scribes, who were the people who were able to learn and write. Craftsmen and peasants. And the last category people were the slaves. The last category people were the slaves. So the first category, king and nobility, upper class, priest, scribes, craft and peasants, then finally slaves. This is how the society was divided. So priest and nobility comes under the upper class, that is especially king's group. Craft and merchant, second one. Ordinary workers, peasants and the slaves comes under the third group. Okay, the slaves means they don't have any rights. That is why it is given as they were not free citizens. Whatever work is assigned to them, they had to do continuously without taking any rest. They cannot take their food. Whatever food is given by the people who control them, that food only they have to take. They don't have any food, proper sleep, proper clothing, etc. So in that civilization, women had more rights than in many later civilizations. So Assyrian civilization, women had more rights. But same way, they were not allowed to attend the schools. Attend the schools means the schools was not in the structure of the building, the way they learned at that time. So they were not allowed to get education at that time. So they were considered as like illiterate. They could not read and write at that time. Even though the women were given a lot of rights, but they were not allowed to get education. Same way, whatever we have seen, all the powerful priests held much political power in the beginning. Military commanders eventually became monarch, creating a new structure of the government called a dynasty. Even the military commanders also, they had lot of powers to create a structure of the government, okay, which was called as a dynasty at the time. Dynasty means like a series of rulers will be there, descending from a single family line. One single family, like we had Babur, Akbar, Humayun, Aurangzeb, all that after the son, father, son, then grandson, like that. From a single family, all the descendants will be ruling that place. That is called what? A dynasty. That is called what? Dynasty. People who belong to the single family, one after the other, they will be ruling that place. That is called what? Dynasty. So the military commanders had that type of government at that time. And usually even that time, the temples were created in order to give protection for the people as well as to do some activities, important activities for the welfare of the people. So inside the temple, they used to have these storehouses. Okay, inside the temple, they used to have these storehouses because storing the grains were under the control of the priest at the time. Okay, so the temples acted as storehouses of the taxed commodities. Tax. So, which shows that even during the civilization, beginning of the civilization itself, they have introduced the tax system also. Tax means the money was not invented, but it was in the kind. Okay. Kind means any products. Assemblies were created for the administration of the state. Assemblies means like how we have Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, the same way group of members will be there for one particular group, another set of people will be there for another group, and they will be meeting together to discuss about what to do. That is called what? Assemblies. Then cultivable lands were owned by the kings and the higher class of the people in the hierarchy. No other, like how we have anybody, whoever has the money, they can own the land. It was not like that. Only the higher class people should have the land with them. Others should work for the rent, or they have to like use the land by paying some rent. This is how the people lived. Not, that's what given. Not all people were allowed to live in the cities. Cities were created. Only the higher class people were allowed to sit in, live in the cities. Other people outside the city only they had to live. So this kind of life they had during the Assyrian civilization, especially Mesopotamian civilization. Let us see food and agriculture. Since the civilization started near the rivers, agriculture was a main occupation. They were the people who developed the irrigation system based on the availability of the water. The crops cultivated were wheat, barley, onions, turnips, grapes, apple, and dates. They domesticated animals like cattle, sheep, goat. Okay? And they started eating fish also. They started eating fish. So this shows that fishing was also another occupation. Agriculture and fishing. Let us see the trade. Few more minutes are left out. So trade alone we will see. Each city-state was also a center of trade. Okay, every city was considered as the center of the state. Though Mesopotamia had the fertile soil and they were able to produce a lot of crops, it had only little wood or stone or no metal ores. That means though they had fertile soil, some of the resources available in Mesopotamian civilization was very less. What kind of resources? Trees, stone, and metals. Okay, no metal ores at all in Mesopotamian civilization. So they had to borrow from the other civilization. These Sumerians traveled far They had to travel far to find out where these resources are found, and they were that they had brought all these resources to their civilization. Okay, so barter system, they followed the barter system, that is exchange of goods against the goods without using money. Okay, fine, have you understood now? Okay, they traded with Syria and Asia Minor in the west and in Iran and the Indus Valley civilization also. Mesopotamian civilization had the trade relationship with Indus Valley civilization. How they travel? They traveled in ships across the seas for trade. And their temples acted as banks and lent credit on their own account. So that time itself, their temples only, they used to have lot of jewels and all the gold coins or something like that. Whatever they considered as a medium of exchange or the wealthy ones, the stones, the precious stones. So it was considered as the bank. Whoever were in need of money, it was given by the temple. Then the Mesopotamian documents have references to loan and repayments. Where we can find all that? People use it to, the scribes use it to maintain the records. Those records acted as the proof how they got loan and how they repaid everything without interest. So this was the first evidence of charging an interest on borrowed money. Okay, so all the temples during that civilization acted as banks. So that time itself, they started their banks also. Okay, children, hope that you have understood. We will learn about all the other contents in the next period. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now. Children, were you able to hear me? Only one person, one boy said that I am not able to hear you. No doubts. Okay, fine. Children, you know how to upload your papers? Very good. Very good. So write neatly. Even the beginning of the exam, you write your name. Sometimes when you upload your paper, your mail may have your parents' name, or it may not be shown also properly. So what you do, like how you do the exam in the paper, same way you start your name and class, then you write all the contents. After writing that, check the number of pages. After taking the photo, after uploading the photo also, you can check the number of pages, whether all the pages are uploaded. Exam ending time, starting time, that ma'am will send you a message. Actually, note is given to you, Noma. Test notes are given to you. So you can write your test in the test notes and take the photo. Then it will be a proof after that, because we may not know whether the schools will be reopened the next month or after 2 months or after 3 months or whatever it is. So anyhow, when you follow a notebook, it will be better. Or if you find it uncomfortable, you can write in the paper and upload it, but see that the papers are maintained neatly. Ending time will be told to you when the exam papers are posted to you, question papers are posted to you, their notifications will be there regarding the exam time. Okay, regarding the exam time. I don't know about the 120 page or 60 page. Please check it out in the office, because I don't know about the notes given to you. Yes, children. So thank you all. We will meet in the next class. All the best for your first exam. Thank you all, children.